In the last few weeks, we haven't seen the production from you that we're accustomed to seeing. What are some of the factors that have played into that?
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to do everything I can. Carson trying to do everything he can at the end of the day to win football games. It really doesn't matter how many targets I have. I've been saying this for years now, whether I had 10 catches or one catch. For me, it's all about finding ways to win a football game. And those big games, those 10-catch games, they're probably going to come. But at the end of the day, we just got to find a way to win. I mean, we're 1-3-1, not exactly the start that we probably envisioned at the start of the year. But we're focused right now on trying to win a football game, whether it be doing a bunch of reps in between periods like Carson and I have always done for years, to be on the same page, talk about it, watch film together, whatever it takes to get on the same page and try and win football games for this team. That's what we're focused on.
Ed and then Kristen.
Hey, Zach, that seems to be the big mystery. I mean, there are times you're open and the ball, you know, comes in high or, you know, isn't thrown, you know, that well, I guess. Why do you think that is, that the chemistry has kind of, you know, not been there so far? At least that's what it looks like between you and Carson.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's one person's fault. I'm not going to sit here and say Carson's missing me all the time when there's times where I got to be better. This is plain and simple. All I can focus on is controlling what I can control. And that's how hard I'm going to work each and every day. And no one's going to outwork me, whether it be here or anywhere else. So we're going to be on the side field, working, trying to get this thing done. Because I haven't had the 7 to 10 catch games yet, doesn't mean they're not coming. And when the times come, I got to be ready. Whatever the team asks me to do at the end of the day is what I'm going to do, whether it is get open on third down, whether it's pass protecting, helping these guys out on the inside, which I've done frequently this year. So whatever the team needs me to do, run blocking, pass pro, running routes on third down, trying to make plays for this team, for me, it doesn't really matter. I'm just trying to win a football game, and then hopefully it'll start Sunday.
Kristen and then Paul.
Hey, Zach, we've talked about this the last couple of weeks, but it feels like teams are really doing a good job of trying to take you away right now. Do you think that has anything to do with the fact that when you look at the receiving corps, there are so many of those young practice squad players, and teams may, you know, rather take a chance with that than try to get you open?
Yeah, I mean, I've seen a lot of different coverages, Kristen. No different than a lot of the other years, honestly. I think there's maybe a little more safety help, per se, at times. So teams are kind of using it as a bracket, per se, even though it's not designed as a bracket at times. A lot of robber, thief coverages. But at the end of the day, if teams are going to do that, other guys are going to make plays, just like Travis did last week. And the more guys make more plays, hopefully there's going to be more space in the middle of the field. And unfortunately, this isn't a situation that we haven't seen before. The past couple of years, at times we've been in this situation where a lot of young guys playing, but frequently those guys come in and make big plays for us. And so I'm excited about the receiver room and how they're progressing. You see the jump that they made from week one to week six that we're in now. So I'm just focused on being a great teammate, helping those guys out any way I can, because those guys really don't know what they don't know in terms of experience. But I'm trying to help any way I can, and the more those guys make plays, the more space they're going to be in the middle of the field.
Paul and then Martin.
Yeah, Zach, last time we talked to you, you had expressed some frustration over where the status of contracts negotiations. A lot of times players just want to put it behind them until after the season, so it doesn't become a distraction. Have you and your agent chosen to do that right now? How are you handling that?
Yeah, last time we talked, actually, Paul, I said I'm not going to talk about it anymore. Two times ago, we talked about it. Haven't talked as much to you guys this year, just with COVID and everything. Last time we spoke, I said that I told everyone to shelve it. I'm not worried about it. I'm not focused. Haven't thought about it. So I'm just trying to find a way to win a football game. The contract stuff doesn't even approach my thought process during the week. My process is all about getting my body right from Monday to Saturday, get my body right to be prepared on Sundays to be the best tight end I could be for this team. And so I'm not worried about that. Whatever happens, happens at this point. I'm just trying to win football games.
Thanks. Martin and then Bo.
Hey, Zach. I know you mentioned earlier that, you know, the amount of receptions or whatever that you might get doesn't affect you, I mean, bother you as long as you guys win. But I was just kind of curious, like, what – I mean, you're obviously a guy who set the record a couple years ago for receptions in a season. I mean, what's your, like, frustration level, I guess, the way things have been going for you personally on the field this year?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say I'm frustrated in my lack of stats. I'm frustrated in the fact that we haven't won football games. And the frustration boils over when you don't win football games. That's what I get frustrated about. I'm not gonna. If we were five and oh right now, and I had the same stats, it wouldn't be. There would be nothing to talk about in my mind. I wouldn't care at all. But I think I can help the team win. I think I can make plays for this team in third down in the red zone like I have in the past, and hopefully try and find a way to win a football game. In terms of frustrations for my stats, you know, this is year eight for me now. I've had a lot of stats. I broke the record, caught the touchdowns and Super Bowl. So for me, it's all about trying to win football games. It's a lot. I said it. The year we won the Super Bowl was a lot more fun than the year I broke the record for catches. So for me, it's all about trying to find ways to win a football game. Because that's a lot more fun to be in this building after a win than it is after a loss, regardless of how many catches you have.
Bo and then Pat.
Zach, do you think Travis Fulgham is for real?
He's been balling, man. He's been balling. He works hard. He's got a smoothness to his game that I think teams are surprised. You know, he gets in and out of his breaks quickly. He's probably faster than people think until they step on the field with him. So I'm excited to see him continue to grow. Obviously, no one wants to be a guy that just has one game, which is a great game. You got to start stacking them games and one game into more games into years. And that's what truly separates people. But from what I've seen, the way he works, I think he's got a chance.
Pat and then Jeff.
Zach, you've never really gone through a tough patch like this. So is it difficult to rid yourself of the frustration when you know some plays that you've made dozens of times before are kind of being left out there?
I mean, there's definitely plays that have been left out there, no doubt about it, not only for me, but as an offense. And the only way I know to get over rough patches is to go out there and work even harder, work as hard as I possibly can. Last year, I think against the Bills, I had two catches. Against the Cowboys, when we were playing down there, I think I had two catches. So it's not like I haven't had these you're not going to go every game with seven catches every game. Otherwise, the record that I had wouldn't have been the record. So you just got to try and find ways to continue to work, whether you're on the top of a mountain coming off 10 catches or whether you're coming off a game with one catch. It's all about the next week and what can you do. It's a different defense each and every week. And the defense we're going against this week is really, 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 really good. So it's going to be a great challenge for us. We're doing everything we can to find a way to win. Really confident in the plan that we have. So I'm excited about this week.
Is there anything extra you do? You mentioned getting more reps in with Carson, but do you dig into more film or anything like that?
You know, my process is the same each and every week, honestly. It's been the same for like the past 4 years now. I talked to Tony Gonzalez after my second year. He said everyone needs a routine of greatness. Well, whatever it is, it's that routine that will keep you consistent. It's that routine that when things are going well will keep you grounded. It's that routine when things are going terrible that will allow you to overcome the obstacle. So for me, it's all about sticking to that routine no matter what's going on, whether I'm gone 4 games in a row with 10 catches or whether I've had 15 yards in 2 games. For me, it's all about this routine, and I'm going to stick to it regardless of what's going on externally. All I can control is myself, and that's all I'm focused on right now.
Skaversky and then Les.
Hey, what's up, Zach? Hope all's well. When you look at just this season, the way it's gone, you talk about the frustration level. How much, with your experience, everything you've been through, the good, the bad, the ugly, can you rely on what you have done in the past for yourself, for this team, to help dig you guys out of this, rely on, you know, your successes from the past?
I mean, that's a great question. I think that's spot on, Jeff. I think, the past couple of years, we've been 4-6 at times. After 10 games, we've been 4-6 and kind of out of the playoff picture per se, needed to start playing really well and start win football games. In both years, we found a way to get into the playoffs, win a football game 1 year, and just came up short last year against the Seahawks. So we definitely have a lot of experience with our backs against the wall, and you can use that as a way to kind of not panic per se, not press to try and make plays. You got to focus on the plays that when they do come your way, you make, but you're not going out there chasing plays. But the Baltimore Ravens don't care about how we've done in the past up to this point in the year. It's going to be a great challenge for us this week. Really looking forward to it. But I think we can lean on our past experiences in this city, especially the past 2 years of kind of starting slow, backs against the wall and guys rallying together and finding a way to win football games.
Last one here with Wes, and then we're going to get Brandon Graham in.
Hey, Zach. You mentioned that defenses aren't playing you that differently. But one thing that's different is you don't have Dallas Goedert out there with you. You're not playing as much 12 personnel. Does that affect, is that a wrinkle that, you know, affects the production in any way?
I don't know. I can't say for sure. I mean, I think the first two games he was out there pretty comparable to what it's been. So I wouldn't say that Dallas is the reason. Obviously, I miss playing with him. He's a phenomenal player. But I don't think the lack of 12 personnel per se is the reason. Either way, in 12 personnel, I'm still going to get a nickel, who's technically the better cover guy than a safety. So I don't think that's the reason. I just think it's the way it's gone, and I'm confident that those games are going, the big games are going to come. And honestly, if they don't and we win a football game, I'm fine with that too. But I don't think the lack of Dallas is the reason.
We were told that Jalen Hurts was giving you looks like Lamar Jackson in practice with the scout team. How is that working for you? And can anybody really give you that duplication of speed you're going to see from Lamar?
Man, honestly, I think Jalen is doing a great job. He did a great job today. And watching film basically all week, giving us a look of, you know, kind of what we'll see. You know, obviously it'll be, you know, the tempo will be a little different on game day, but I think Jalen's been doing a, you know, really good job at it. And, you know, he's taking it serious, you know. He ain't messing around with it, especially, you know, a guy like him, a rookie, you know, being asked to do such a, you know, give an example for, you know, for our starting defense. I think he's been doing a really good job for us.
Kristen and then Ed.
Hey, Fletch, this is more of a big picture question, but it feels like there's been some more inconsistency from this team. You know, when the offense is shining, the defense, you know, may not be there, and kind of vice versa. Is there anything from past years that you can pull on to kind of get through that challenge right now and find consistency on both sides of the ball?
Man, I don't think it's consistency. I think the thing is, you know, about this team, you know, we just have to play a complete game. We just got to put, like, one complete game together. And, you know, I think, you know, that's something we kind of struggled to do here lately. But we just got to, I mean, the 49ers game, we put a complete game together, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, it was up and down last week. But, you know, right now we're just focusing on the Ravens this week and, you know, working on and need to put that complete game together.
We'll go Ed and then Martin.
Hey, Fletch. You and Zach Ertz have been teammates for, you know, eight years, I guess, now. Good friends. What, you know, he's struggling a little bit. What do you see from him, you know, in the locker room or on the field at practice? See any change in him or is he still the same person going through these struggles?
I mean, as a teammate, I would never come out and say, as you know, say one of my teammates is struggling or, you know, showing bad energy. I think the biggest thing is, you know, he's Zach. You know, I talk to Zach every day before practice, doing warm-ups practice. You know, his locker is, you know, right behind mine's on the other side of the locker room. All I could do is turn back. And, you know, Zach has been himself, you know. So I think he's in a good spot, and, you know, he'll be all right.
Go ahead, Martin.
Hey, Fletch, what's the toughest thing about the Ravens' running game? I mean, not only do you have to worry about Lamar Jackson, but also, you know, their running backs and everything like that. So what makes it so tough to, you know, play against them?
I think it's just going to come down to us being disciplined, you know. You know, guys just being where they need to be and tackling. Once a guy get there, you know, get him on the ground, no missed tackles, breaking a tackle. Just get to him, get him on the ground. I think that's, you know, that's the going thing around here. You get the guy on the ground, you know, team tackle, group tackle, 11 guys there. And, you know, obviously it's going to come out to be a good day.
Obviously, we talk about discipline on the pass rush every week. Jim stresses that. But how much more important is it this week with Lamar?
You know, it's always important, like you said, every week. But this week particularly is because, you know, he can run and he can get out of there, you know, fast. And so we got to just – we can't rush scared, but, you know, we do got to rush responsible, and we got to make sure we're on the same page.
Hey, Kristen, and then Paul Domowicz.
Hey, Brandon, it's been a few days since the news came out, but first time talking with you. Fans back in the stands at Lincoln Financial Field, what's that going to mean for you guys? And how big of a push can that be on some of these big, you know, third down stops to have Birds fans behind you guys again?
It's going to feel good because, you know, that's another energy that that we need. You know, we need the fans, you know, we need the crowd noise. I mean, at the end of the day, it does do something to you, and not having it shows you that. So I'm excited for it. Can't wait for it.
If I can follow up real quick, did you feel like that was something that this team was missing the first few games?
I feel like that's what everybody was missing. I mean, you know, it's kind of crazy after the national anthem, you usually hear like a big roar after. Now it's kind of, it's just silent, you know. And so you hear teams yelling and all that stuff, but, you know, it's nothing like hearing the crowd.
Okay, Damo and then John Clark.
Hey, Brandon. We were talking to Nikhil yesterday, and he was saying that he's noticed Lamar is trying to be more of a quarterback this year, more of a drop back guy, trying to make reads. Have you noticed that? And does it give you guys a little bit of help up front? Because that means, yes, he'd be holding the ball a little bit longer.
I mean, from what I've seen, yeah, he is trying to stay back there and make them throws. They still coming out pretty fast, too. But I do see him a lot differently than, you know, we did seeing him last year. I think that, you know, of course, he's trying to be great every year. He's trying to do something different as far as, you know, getting better in the area of just staying back there. And I think that, you know, that's something that I do see on film.
Hey, John Clark and then Jeff Skowronski.
Hey, Brandon, what kind of job is Jalen Hurts doing in practice for you guys, showing you all the different looks that Lamar is going to give you, and how important is that?
He's giving us a great look. So far, so good. Yesterday was really good, seeing the speed of what we're going to see. Of course, he's not Lamar, but he's fast too. So to see the speed of what they were showing us and how fast things happen, it's definitely going to help for Sunday. I think that, you know, with him, that played right into what he does. So just him giving us that great look is definitely going to help on Sunday.
And real quick, you said you would know Wednesday from the NFL whether you had that penalty there. Did you find out from the NFL with a fine if
no,
it was called incorrectly?
I haven't got that fine at all.
There you go. Thank you.
Jeff Skowronski and then Jeff McClain.
Brandon, obviously you're watching tape of Lamar studying what he does, but are there any other quarterbacks and you know, experiences that you guys have had the last few years of quarterbacks that you also go, okay, well, this worked against this guy, it can help us with Lamar?
Nope. You just gotta, cause Lamar's different. You know, at the end of the day, you know, you gotta stop their run. You know, it's all kind of guys. Anybody I could think of is RG3. Definitely the way he ran it in Washington. You know, he ran it the same way. And you know, that was a guy that was fast, but Lamar is he turned it up a little notch, you know, of how fast he's getting out of there and how we got to stay disciplined for real, because, you know, this guy is a home run hitter at any given moment.
What's the key to stopping him?
Do your job. Be disciplined. You got to make sure that you rally to the ball. Like, you know, you got, I mean, because what I've seen is, you know, he's getting hit. He's gotten hit, but it's been teams that that D-line run to the ball, that linebackers, everybody's running to the ball because he's going to make somebody miss, but the next guy not needs to be taking his shot once the first guy take his shot.
Thank you.
Jeff McClain and then Martin Frank.
BG, sorry if you've been asked about – have you been asked about Jack Driscoll yet?
This must be Jeff. That must be Jeff talking.
Yeah. I missed the first part. Were you asked about Driscoll yet? I don't want
to have. No, I didn't. I haven't.
Okay. He was talking about how before the first game, one of the things that really helped him was that the D-lineman came up to him. The guys he'd been working against all throughout training camp and had voices, you know, they voiced their support for him just based upon what he had done. Do you recall that moment? Were you one of the guys? And what did you say to him?
Yeah, you know, I just told him, like, you can do this, man. You haven't seen no D-line. I mean, it don't get no better than us because we don't have too much responsibility. We just getting off and, you know, going. And so I was like, man, you done seen it. Now just go trust yourself. And that's pretty much, you know, was my message to him because, you know, at that point, if he ain't got it, he ain't got it right now. You know, but I think that just encouragement goes a long way and to let him know we got his back. And so I think he was able to play free with some of the guys that came up to him.
Did you get his name right that time? Did you get his name right?
Oh,
that
yeah,
time?
Yeah. Now, I know how to do all that. Spell it and everything.
What's his first name? Yeah. What's his first name?
Jack.
Okay, Martin Frank, and then Zach Berman, and then this will be our last two.
Hey, BG, you were asked earlier about Jalen Hurts in practice, like simulating Lamar. But more in general, like on Jalen, like have you seen like a lot of the characteristics that Lamar Jackson has as far as his running and his throwing? I mean, would he be a quarterback who's comparable to him?
I think that you know, they are very similar. You know, I think that what's the name? Probably Jalen probably has started trying to be more of a pocket passer, because that's what he's done for us since he's been here. Just, you know, you see his speed, you see him running and stuff, but he's really been, you know, more of a pocket passer, trying to make sure he get the throws, make the reads. And, you know, I can see that, you know, that's an elevation in his game that I see that he took to another level just by watching him every day.
Okay, last one here for Zach Berman.
Hey, Brandon, your linebackers have come under scrutiny this week and this season. How do you think that group playing, and is there anything particular about them that you have to be in the defense to either understand or appreciate?
I mean, I think they're playing good. You know, I just think that, you know, mistakes happens in the games, and, you know, some mistakes are magnified even more because of what position Nate Gary was in at the time. But I do think that, you know, we got some good guys back there. You know, we got Nate, we got, why can't I think of, you know who I'm talking about. Louisiana.
Yeah, you got Duke Riley.
Duke last game, you know, was everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Like, I love his energy. I think that, you know, we got some guys that's just finding their way. The first time starting, you know, with Duke coming in for us, you know, at linebacker full time. And I think that Duke is, you know, getting better every week. I think that, you know, we just got to continue to keep on building that chemistry, keep on building that confidence, and just trusting in them, which I do. You know, we all trust in each other, and encouragement go a long way. And I think, you know, we've been doing that, and we're going to continue to keep getting better every week.
I've heard you guys are using Jalen Hurts as your Lamar Jackson in practice this week. How's he handled that role, and how much is it helping you guys prepare?
Yeah, it's helped us out a lot. He understands the scheme, the zone read scheme, and his athleticism, I think, speaks for itself. And so he's putting that on display for us throughout this week, giving us a real good look, scrambling around, whether it's design runs or it's him just doing things similar to Lamar Jackson, and then also having the ability, you know, to throw the ball down the field. So, and for us as a defensive back group, man, staying in coverage is going to be big this week for us, understanding how Lamar Jackson likes to make his plays. So we've been getting a very good look, and it's exciting to see, man, and go against. I'm not sure, you know, how the speed, whether it's similar or not, but it's good enough.
John and then Les.
Hey, Rod. This team's really good in the run game, and Lamar's a big part of that as well. But the tight ends are a big part of their offense as a safety. How is that going to impact you that they do both so well, use their tight ends and run the football?
Yeah, I mean, first and foremost, it's stopping a run for us. That's where it starts and ends. That's their engine that drives that team and that offense. Whether, you know, they're handing the ball off to Mark Ingram or it's, you know, Lamar Jackson being the dynamic player that he is and getting out on the edge, we have to make them one-dimensional as much as possible. Understanding he does like his tight ends. Those are his favorite, you know, outlets outside of Brown, you know, that he likes to stretch the field with. So we have a great understanding on what they want to do and how they like to attack teams. So it's really up to us. We have to play disciplined football. We have to have population to the ball, and we have to tackle well.
Less than Rube.
Hey, Rod, I was wondering if you could remember back to last summer, the joint practices with the Ravens, and what your impressions of, I think you were back practicing by then, if I remember.
Yeah.
What your initial impressions of Lamar was, and just how far he's come as far as being a quarterback and not just an athlete.
Yeah, so what was, I guess, unique about that practice week, he didn't do much running versus us in practice. And, you know, quickly,
without him running the football, the offense looks totally different. And we didn't get a, you know, full experience of their offense that week because, like I said, he really stayed in the pocket. I think they wanted to lessen the risk of him, you know, injuring himself, and which is smart by them. At that point, there's no need. But, I mean, you look at them throughout the season and you see the impact that he has on the ground game as well as his passing ability. So I'm excited to go against him this week. You know, it's a very great team, good offense, and we have to play lights out, man, this week in order to win this game.
Lesson and Mike.
Hey, Rod. We were talking to Nickell Roby-Coleman yesterday about man defense, and you know, a lot of the guys haven't played that much of it here. How do you see that transition? What's been difficult in it?
I think, you know, it's just every all of us getting used to one another, understanding how to, you know, communicate the way that we want to play stacks, bunches, all of those sorts of things. When you're a man team, particularly on third down the way that we are, teams are going to try to schematically, you know, get you to communicate, make sure, you know, get you on a different level, whether it's picks, things of that nature. So we understand that, and we've done a better job at that, you know, this week, just making sure we understand every single alignment, however they want to try to attack us. We understand where we need to be, how we're going to play it. And then this is about going out and competing. And I feel like this group does that well, and we'll do better this week on third down. But I think that's all predicated on us as being man team, and teams just, like I said, running a lot of stacks, bunches, getting us to overly communicate, and we got to do a bit better job with that.
Mike and then Zach.
Hey, Rod. I know you worked with Will Parks during the offseason, now him coming back. What does he bring to the field? What does he bring to the locker room? How much can he help this team this week if he's available?
Energy. That's the first word that comes to mind for Will Parks, man. He's a very energetic guy, comes to work every day, ready. He's a guy that's shown that he has the ability to do it all. Has made a lot of plays, you know, for us in camp, and, you know, unfortunately he went down with an injury. Now, you know, he's back, and he's been doing that this week, man. He's a guy that you could plug in anywhere. Hey, you want him to play linebacker, okay. You want him to play center field, do that. You want him to rush the passer, he can get it done. So that's what I like most about Will. I'm excited for him this week, for him to get back out here, play in front of, you know, his hometown, and, you know, make some plays for us on defense.
We have time for a few more, so we'll go Zach, Damo, and Chris.
Hey, Rodney, the linebackers on this team have come under public scrutiny. I'm curious, you know the defense as well as anyone. Is there anything you can share that kind of shows maybe what they do that we in the media and fans don't see?
I mean, I love my linebacker crew, whether it's Snake, whether it's Duke, you know, Singleton, the young fella, DT, and you got Sean Bradley, you know, from Jersey. But, man, they all rally to the ball. They tackle well. They understand, you know, schematically they get our defense lined up. I mean, in my books, I love them. I like them each and every week. And you see them coming up with big plays. Alex Singleton makes an interception versus San Francisco. Snake countlessly, you know, in the backfield where he's supposed to be. Duke, you know, last week had a major game and forced fumble. I mean, they continue to make plays. So, not sure. We know what we have in that linebacker group. And like I said, I like them each and every week.
Damo and then Chris.
Hey, Rod. When we were talking to Nickell yesterday about Lamar, he was saying that what he's noticed on film about him and from having seen him in the past is that he's trying to be more of a quarterback this year, dropping back more, looking to read coverages a little bit more. Have you noticed that? And how helpful is it as far as your pass rush having a little bit more time to get there?
Yeah, you do see him trying to get the ball out and work on a lot more timing. Him noticing the pressure, finding his outlets a lot quicker. But he still has the ability to escape. He's still creating plays with his, you know, with his legs. And what I mean by that, he's able to escape the pressure. He's able to escape the rush. But what he's doing is still looking down the field. And that's what you see a lot more. So we just have to do a good job in the back end at plastering. And then obviously up front have to, you know, contain him as much as possible and get him on the ground when we can.
Last question here with Chris.
Hey, Ron, you had a quick question. What's it saying in your T-shirts as players play or don't opt out?
Oh, yeah, players play or opt out. The little shirt, yeah, designed by yours truly. Then it's got some stuff on the back and everything. Thought it was fitting for 2020 to give people something to remember this by.
Lamar Jackson this week, obviously a lot of emphasis on that. How does that dual threat ability affect you guys at the cornerback position when you have somebody that can do so many different things?
He's definitely good with the ball in his hands. He can create a lot of opportunities for his receivers after route, so we definitely have to do good plastering and stuff like that. But he's a phenomenal player, great kid, and he can make a lot of plays with his feet, obviously.
We'll go to Martin and then Dave.
Hey, Trayvon. I was wondering what kind of challenge do their tight ends bring both in the receiving game and also in blocking?
Come again, you was a little low.
What kind of challenge do the Ravens bring, their tight ends bring in the receiving game and also as blockers?
Oh, man, those guys are not afraid to block. 89 is definitely a guy who can bring versatility to the receiving core. We definitely know that he's a favorite target of Lamar. And as far as receivers too, Marquise Brown, he's a speedster guy, you know, goes downfield, like to go deep. Definitely, I think he's the second option as well too. And they can bring a lot of juice out there as far as blocking in the pass game.
Go ahead, Dave.
Hey, Craven. Jalen Hurts in practice, kind of mimicking Lamar this week. What have you seen from him, and how much does that help to have a guy like that you can put out there and kind of give you those looks?
Oh, man, that helped tremendously. He's been doing a phenomenal job for us out at practice, giving us great looks all week. So we're definitely grateful for that and to have him back there giving us those good looks.
We'll go to Ed Kratz next.
Hey, Craven, if I could just follow up on that question. You know, we don't get to see Jalen Hurts practice a lot. How has he kind of evolved from, you know, the training camp days until now? We saw he completed his first pass on Sunday. How have you seen him kind of evolve into his professional football career here?
I think he's handling his progress very well as a player. He's definitely a guy, a team first guy, you know, whatever coach asks him to do, he does. And that's all that we can ever ask of him to do. And whatever look he gives us is a great appreciation to this team and to the defense.
I guess we can start with you making your NFL debut. You're probably chomping at the bit for that to happen. It was delayed. How did it feel to get out there finally?
Honestly, I was relieved. I was happy. I was ready to go out there and, you know, try to make some plays, do my role, and do what I could to help the team win.
We'll go Mike and then John Clark.
As the room seems to be filling up at wide receiver, you guys got a lot of talented guys in there. You know, I think when Jalen comes back, he'll have 8 wide receivers in that room. Do you feel like you guys have to compete every day with each other to kind of hang on because the room is so talented? And what have you done behind the scenes to kind of prove yourself moving forward?
In this league, every day you got to compete. Y'all know this is a job, so every day you got to come in, compete, do your job, play your role. And for me, it's just I'm trying to stay after practice, work on my techniques, get my footing down, catch balls, do whatever I can to always either stay ahead or catch up, either one I need to do. But most likely, I always try to stay ahead.
John and then Les.
Hey, Quez. Sometimes the start of a career can be a little bumpy. You know, you had an injury. And then you look at Travis Fulgham, who was also a sixth-round pick last year, and how he bounced around a little bit. Do you see what's happened with him, and can he serve as inspiration to you about how to go about things and get to where you want to go?
For me, I know it's always control what you can control. For me, I know God has a plan for me, no matter if it's now, no matter if it's 2 years later. I always know that just come to work every day, put my hard hat on, and keep pushing forward. I'm always inspired just by playing a game, honestly.
Last and then Martin.
It was. You were out for a good while there. What was that like, and what did you have to do to get back? And had you been in that situation previously, in your football career?
For me, being out, just watching everybody practice, have fun, I was really ready to get back and enjoy the moment, be with my guys, and make some plays. But I knew I had to, you know, stay down, get healthy, and take care of my body and really be locked in the mindset and mentally on the playbooks and everything that was going on. And for me, I had to sit out two games last season in college. So, I've done that before. I bounced back pretty well. And right now I'm just coming here to do my part and play ball.
Martin and then Daniel.
Hey, Quez. I was kind of wondering, you know, you missed pretty much a month with your injury, and then you didn't have, you know, any preseason games and stuff. What did you notice about, like, the speed of the game last week, and how much catching up did you have to do in order to get ready?
Like, honestly, the speed of the game is always faster in game than it is in practice. So really just a process of hearing everything, going out there, knowing you got a clock winding down and stuff like that. So you just got to always be a step ahead, know what you're doing, and always just play fast.
Daniel and then John.
Hey, Quez, at the beginning of training camp, we saw your chemistry with Carson Wentz. You know, while you were out, how did you kind of keep building that, and what kind of things did you do off the field to do that?
Off the field, well, you know, when it comes to the sideline or anything like that, when I sit around the building, I kind of, like, he try to pick my brain, see what I know, see if I'm actually engaged in the game plan, even though I'm not playing. So I do that, and then I try to pick his brain some too. Like, when he's, maybe we watch film or we just got off the field or something, I might ask him, what he prefer on this or what he prefer on that, anything like that. So we really just picking each other's brain as we go along. And for me, when I come back, I already know what he wants and what he expects.
Go ahead, John.
Hey, Quez. Just curious, obviously this year, more than any other, is probably difficult for rookies because of the virtual offseason. From the time you finally got here till now, how much have things slowed down for you? And do you see a big difference?
Honestly, when I got in, everything always looked so different for the first time. So when I first got here, everything looked different. It's like people was talking in tongue, and now it's just like the game slowed down, and it's kind of like it's really back to normal. I got comfortable. I can finesse my routes, do what I need to do, and different stuff like that. So now I kind of feel like I got more leeway because I'm learning the system, and I kind of it's like I've been here.
We have time for two more, so we'll go Dave and then Mike.
Hey, Quez, I wanted to kind of follow up on something you mentioned about Carson. You said he was kind of like seeing if you were engaged when you weren't playing. Was that him kind of testing a rookie, do you think? And do you appreciate him kind of holding everyone accountable?
Yeah, I do. I do feel like that was the whole reason. Like, maybe what if I came back and I had to be the man up, do what I know what I was doing, and That's really the thing he was trying to see. Like, when I come back, can he have trust in me to make plays and know what I'm doing? And with that, I feel like it was just steady building and building.
Go ahead, Mike.
Quez, I know you only played a handful of snaps against the Steelers, but to get that kind of out of the way, how can you kind of build on that, at least from a mindset stability-wise, moving on into these next couple of games?
My mindset is, you know, want to play more snaps and contribute, help my team win a game, no matter if it's a block 30 yards down the field for somebody to score, or if it's, you know, picking up a fumble, anything, like whatever it is, I just want to do my job and help this team win games.